I'm really glad I attended today's workshop on the food mood connection here at the YMCA. I learned a lot about, you know, the effects that food have on my body, and what was particularly important to me was to learn about how to better manage stress through my diet, because my job is very stressful. I also appreciated the fact that certain misconceptions, certain misinformation that I would have gotten over the years was cleared up at today's workshop.
Some of you may be familiar with the YMCA. We've been here for 21 years. And our new focus is going to be on whole mind, body, spirit. If you're familiar with the YMCA, that's an international mandate of the organization. We are here to build people's minds, their bodies, and their spirits.
So, when you are stressed out, what happens in your body? We don't think about it. So what we have to understand moving forward is that every day we have to eat and live mindfully. And that is what we don't do. The minute you get stressed, you don't know it, but there are chemicals that are instantly released in your body. The stress response takes the body 12 seconds. In 12 seconds, there are a series of chemicals that come into your body the minute you decide to be stressed. Deficiencies in tyrosine. Tyrosine gives you dopamine and noradrenaline, right? Tyrosine gives you dopamine and noradrenaline. So this keeps you perked up. It aids your focus and it aids your alertness. And this is also important during the course of your day to be in a good mood. You want to get the correct types of foods to give you the correct chemicals for your brain. Your food is broken down into chemicals for your brain. It's a simplistic way of saying it, but generally that is what happens.
We are dealing with special ed children with special needs, and we have already started making the connection between what sort of diet these children could have to help with the disability. So I found that the link that she was talking about was very interesting to us, and that is one of the main reasons that I am here today. One of the things I would take away from the workshop is that how brain-based learning has a strong connection with what we eat, you know, and how it regulates the biology of the body. And I think that is the most important thing, because everything that she spoke about, it starts with the brain. And I think that is something that we need to understand, that the body cannot function without the brain, and the brain cannot function without food. And that is where she connected the food and the mood, and she made that link.
Dr. Keisha Roberts was very much on point with her delivery and the content. She talked about a lot of things that we tend to overlook. For instance, she talked about supplements, and she asked a question like, who would be taking supplements and why? And sometimes, you know, we take supplements because it's advertised that, you know, this is something that you need, and not necessarily that we need it. We think we need it, because once we eat the right foods, not necessarily we need to take supplements as a means to, you know, being healthier. So that was something that I think was very, very important, and it was highlighted, and it made me more aware of what I need to eat to be healthy and not necessarily get it from supplements.